The off-Broadway show Spamalot stopped by the Geroge Daily Auditorium on Tuesday. The nationally touring show came to Oskaloosa from Alabama before continuing on to Wisconsin. About 500 theater-goers enjoyed the performance. I stopped by the auditorium to learn what it takes to make the show go on.
We carry all of our own lighting equipment and sound equipment and all of the scenic stuff and costumes and props.
Production supervisor Janae Lena has a lot of experience in touring theater.
About 10 years.
And knows a thing or two about how things get done.
We start in the morning by getting lighting up in the air first. Carpentry hangs all of the pieces that fly in and out, and then they put down our floor. Then they work on building the scenic pieces.
It's a process that runs like a well-oiled machine.
We do this every day.
But it's not without help.
We couldn't do all of this on our own, certainly not day after day.
Today, that help is coming from a group of about 50 volunteers that arrived at the auditorium at 7:30 in the morning for a safety meeting from technical director Mike Fisher.
It's so amazing to see 40, 50 people come out and volunteer their time and do a job that most people get paid to do, but we do it just out of love for our community theater.
After the meeting, the action begins as the crews unload three semis full of equipment, filling every space available backstage. And as the boxes unload, lights are hung, cables connected, and curtains tied.
They work pretty much 8 hours putting it all together.
With the volunteers doing a majority of the lifting.
We're putting on off-Broadway shows in a small town, which is just unheard of, and it's because of the volunteer factor behind it.
The Geroge Daily has brought in 14 other off-Broadway productions of similar scale since 2002, something that doesn't come cheap.
Very, very expensive shows to bring in.
And the volunteers help that expense be more manageable, along with charitable donations.
Friends of the Auditorium is what makes it possible, because we don't make enough ticket sales to pay for these.
Placing the value more on the experience than the profit.
Because we want to make the arts accessible for Oskaloosa and this part of the Iowa.
For the audience to be entertained, and for the volunteers that are students from the high school and William Penn to experience a unique career opportunity.
Not just opportunities from networking for jobs, but finding out what are some of the other occupations that are available if you have an interest in theater other than just being a star on the stage.
As for Janae, she prefers to be a star behind the scenes, communicating with the crew during the show to make sure everything runs smoothly.
This is the command center of the show. This will be a front of house camera feed. These are all of the different headset channels, the different comm channels. So I talk to the carpenters on deck, the electricians, the spot booth, and also sound. I also have here a control box. These are called cue lights. When the light goes on, that's a cue for them to stand by to move whatever piece is moving. And when the light goes out, then it goes.
The volunteers eventually stay till 1:30 in the morning, loading the three semis back up for the show to move on to the next theater in La Crosse, Wisconsin.